second project is called leaf chromatography. Many people think that leaves have only one color, which is green, no other colors. But that is very wrong.
Okay.
So that was the goal of answering that question of this project. So first you have to find...
So the question was, what are the different colors in a leaf? Is that the question?
No, how to find the different colors in the leaf.
What are the...
Yes. So first you should find different leaves of different colors, mm-hmm. as shown. Then you should mash them up into bits and put them into separate test tubes.
Did you just mash it with pound? Like you pounded
it? Like this. And then you should put rubbing alcohol into each of the test tubes.
Okay.
So, and after that, you should let it be like that for one full day. So, then in the morning, you should put filter paper strips into each of the test tubes and let it be like that for 5 hours or so. So, after 5 hours, when you remove the filter paper strips from the test tubes, you will see these colors. It was darker before, but because rubbing alcohol just evaporates into the air, we couldn't help it.
Okay. And so what are the different colors you found?
Different colors like red, brown, yellow, mature green, yellow green, yellow brown, new green.
So from red to green and...
Yeah, yellow and brown.
Okay.
So this is a very... fun experiment because you get to find different colors in a leaf.
Okay.
So you see mostly these different colors of leaves in the winter, because in the winter the plants and the trees recall all the chlorophyll from the leaves and store them in their storage cells, since there is no sun. Since there is no chlorophyll, the other colors take the spotlight and shine through.
So these, the colors that you showed, like brown, can you open that page for me? The brown leaf was like in the winter, was a winter leaf.
Yes.
Or this yellowing one.
Yes.
It's Neelesh. Kerala. So my experiment is the fastest way to drain water. So this is the normal way. We just tip the water bottle down, let gravity do its thing.
Yeah.
So what happens here is, a lump of water falls down, and so it creates a vacuum.
Uh-huh.
So the air has to get in. So the water speeds up and slows down because of air. The next way is to create a vortex by swirling the bottle. What happens here is, the air gets in through the center and pushes the water down from the sides.
So that was the faster one.
The fastest one is to use a straw and blow through it.
Nice.
Here, there's an extra passage through which the air can get in and push the water down from the bottle. There will be no disruption between the flow of air and flow of water.
Now, how does a submarine work? The submarine has a compartment which first is filled with air so it can float. Later on, when we want it to go down, we let the air come out and let the water come in, like so. So now, as you can see, as it is filled with water, it is started going down. And now when we want it to come back up to the surface, we let out the water and let the air come in. To make it faster, I'll just take it out like this. Now, as you can see, the water is coming out and the air is going into it, making it less dense. And now it can float again. This is how the submarine works.
Can you explain what a buoyant force is that you were talking about?
The force from the water, which acts upwards,
pushed upwards.
It helps the object to float.
My name is Rudrangsh Sanjeev Guha from Class 3B, Sri Sri Ravi Shankar Vidya Mandir, Mulund, Mumbai. So, imagine a reservoir of water directly on top of a water turbine that is fixed to the wheels of the car. So, as the water from the turbine falls, water from the reservoir falls on the turbine, the potential energy contained in the water gets converted to kinetic and rotational energy and makes the turbine move, which in turn makes the wheels of the car move and eventually the entire car move. And do you know that this invention can be used to save farmers' lives?
Really?
How? Yes. In the last 20 years, more than 684,000 farmers have committed suicide just because of lack of irrigation. And irrigation is the backbone of agriculture. So, whenever we think of irrigation, we always think that drip irrigation, water sprinklers, etc. But they always have some use of fossil fuels. And that's two major setbacks for farmers. Because, first of all, fossil fuels lead to more greenhouse gas emissions and makes climate change even worse. And climate change is solely responsible for rain happening in the wrong time and not happening at the correct time. Their profit margin decreases drastically because fossil fuel prices are increasing, skyrocketing in the market. So mine is a clean, green, and a renewable source of energy, water. So whenever you think of water cars, you always think of the electrolysis of water that's turning it into two hydrogen and one oxygen atom, and then combining them together to form energy. But like the Toyota Mirai, but mine is actually a water car because it works on water. And for some add-on, you can also add natural fertilizers like nitrate into the water so that it also waters as well as fertilizes the crops as well. So,
can I ask you a question? So this vehicle you're imagining is going to be on the field watering plants?
Yes.
Okay.
So when I grow up, I'll try to make a better model of this. When my motor skills improve, I'll use industrial grade materials and I'll make it bigger. And I even may put a valve here to like control it. And I'll make a larger version of it so that it will be more efficient, and I'll sell this on the market to farmers, and this can actually touch farmers' lives. Can't it touch farmers' lives? Can't it save farmers?
Definitely it'll have an impact. And does this move?
Yes.
Oh, okay. Have you tried it, or is it just a model?
Yeah, I can work. So, I'll first have to close this first, and then I'll take the water.
Do you need me to help you in some way?
I'll pour some water here, and when I leave it, this will actually work. It will actually work. But while traveling, it actually kind of broke
a
little bit.
Yeah, but we get an idea of how. So we saw the wheels spinning a bit. Yeah.
So this is my magnetic spinning top. So I have attached a magnet in this plastic half-cut ball. And I have sticked a colorful paper disc. And now this magnet is easily attached to this steel hanger. So now it is spinning.
Oh.
And it is this magnetic spinning top is spinning because of the gravitational force and the curved face of the ball. Thank you.
What's your name?
Sandvi.
Thank you.
Project is hydrophobic and hydrophilic materials.
What is hydrophobic?
Hydrophobic material means materials which repel the water.
Okay.
And hydrophilic materials means materials which are attracted by water.
So I won't be able to see everything.
Yes.
Which was the one that you were most surprised by? That, oh, this is hydrophobic, or this is...
Yes.
Which one did you find when you were doing your experiment? Which is the most interesting one?
Ma'am, silicon ash.
Can you show me?
Yes, ma'am.
Is that going to be liking water or not liking water? Hydrophobic or...
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, it is hydrophobic.
Carbon dioxide underground.
Oh, it makes little like balls. That's very.
However, hydrogen can also be produced by water.
Where are you from?
I'm from Bhubaneswar.
Oh wow, you come from a far. What are you showing us?
So basically, this is a model I've created to solve my mom's real life problem of cleaning the fan.
Okay.
Basically, there are three pulleys here. These two pulleys are only for our handling purpose, and this pulley is directly connected to the fan. If we just turn this axle, the fan will lower itself, and when we turn it back, it will go back up.
Okay. And what did you use to construct your model?
These are some simple Lego pieces,
okay.
And I found these pulleys as well, so I just connected them all and glue gunned them to this car.
Uh-huh. Okay, thank you.
You can also take a look at this if you want. I'm from Bangalore.
Okay.
So this is my project. It's called the uphill roller.
Okay.
So, yes. So, I've taken a sloping surface made up of cardboard and two sharpeners, very simple. And then I've taken a glue stick and you can see, it's rolling down. But if I take this arrangement and I place it over here, common sense will say it will roll downwards. But now, it rolls upwards. The reason is very simple. Generally, in these cylinders, the center of mass is there.
Okay.
But here, due to the nails, the center of mass is shifted. Now, due to the shift of the center of mass, I keep these nails at 11 o'clock position.
Okay.
And now, by placing them in the 11 o'clock position, it creates an apparent movement by which the whole body moves uphill. This is also a very interesting toy which explains the same concept. It's like you push it and it comes back. It's a balloon doll.
Can I see?
Yeah.
It always comes back to
its
starting position.
That's because of a coin that I've placed. So because of this coin, it always tends not to fall and just stays upright. Here I've experimented with different places where I can keep the nail. Where different places where I can keep the nail, you can see that 11 o'clock you saw it rolled.
Yeah.
But if I keep the same arrangement at 8 o'clock position, it will not roll at all. It's balancing. But if I keep it at 1 o'clock position at great speed, it tends to move downwards. So this is a very fun experiment in which you can explain the center of mass concept.
Namaste, I'm Tilak. I'm in 9th grade. So,
where are you from, Tilak?
I'm from Pune.
Oh, you're from Pune, okay.
Okay, so have you ever wondered how our toilets work? There are no electrical connections, neither are there any motor pressures and all that stuff. We just have to press this button over here and all the residue gets flushed out. So how's that possible? So here's this little cup called Pythagoras cup.
Here,
so you can see it from inside. Now, when I fill water inside it, nothing's happening. Even after it crosses the opening, nothing happens. But as soon as it crosses this topmost point, water starts to flow. Why? Because this water has crossed this point and then gravity is pulling it down. As gravity is pulling it down, all the water starts flowing, and due to cohesion, all water are attracting each other. And because of that, the water falls as if it's a chain. Similarly, in this toilet system, this is the normal scenario. This is the normal level of water. When we press the flush button, water starts filling in this bowl and the level of water increases. As soon as it crosses this point, water falls down due to gravity and cohesion. So all the residue completely goes out. and we have a clean toilet.
Let's start with a short story. One day I was going through YouTube casually, and then I came about these two ancient artifacts. And then I found it quite interesting, and months later I got to know about Ramen Awards, and I was like, yes, I gotta do these two, because I wanted to represent a part of me, what I adore. I love clay sculpting, I love our ancient artifacts, I love things which depict something existed in the past. So
is this something, is that related to the magic Krishna jar?
Yes, magic Krishna jar and anti-gravity jar both are replicas of ancient Indian artifacts.
Can you show us just one?
Sure, I'll go with this one. Okay, so the original jar is 300 years old and is located at the Chennai Museum of India. So as you can see, there's a large bowl over here, a Krishna idol, and another one below for collecting water. This works on the principle of a siphon and is known for defying the laws of gravity and physics. Now, I shall be pouring water into the large bowl over here. And what do you think will happen? Any guesses? There's a pipe below over here.
So it's going to come into the container below it?
Alright, let's see. Basically, this is the viewpoint over here. You can observe from there.
Yeah. Did you make the fountain?
Yes. As you can see, the water level increases instead of decreasing or coming out through the hole or the pipe. Let's now carefully observe what happens when it bypasses Lord Krishna's feet.
So the laws of reflection, the first one states that the incident tree and the normal and the reflected tree, all of them die.
As you can see, as it touches Lord Krishna's feet or bypasses it, the water starts coming out through the hole. As I said, this works on the principle of a siphon. I've got the diagram of a siphon over here, but due to water, I used sketch pens and it got smudged off.
So
there's a hidden pipe over here, and when I initially poured water into it, the water level in the pipe and the water level in the jar had to be at the same level. However, when I start pouring water into it, both of them increase simultaneously. And when the pipe is completely submerged on the water, or you could say that the required level for the siphon to be activated is reached, the siphon is activated and water starts coming out through the pipe. It doesn't stop until all of it comes out.
Right.